Oh, nice.
Parents will tell you kids say and do the darndest things.
We used to laugh and call him an old man.
Quirky and cute, says Erica Ruhlman, that her two-year-old son Luke seemed obsessed with safety in and around their suburban Cincinnati home.
Very cautious about, like, crossing the street, anything that might be hot or dangerous or high.
And then there was that other fixation.
I think I specifically asked him, why did you name the ladybug Pam? And he said, I just think it's a nice name.
Soon, everything was Pam, with increasingly peculiar comments.
He used to say, when I was a girl, I had black hair. Or he'd say, I used to have earrings like that when I was a girl.
The stay-at-home mom wondered, where was he getting these ideas? Luke's answer changed their lives forever.
I was like, who is Pam? You know, out of frustration. And that's when he turned to me and looked at me and said, well, I was. And I was like, what do you mean you were? And he was like, well, I used to be, but I died and I went up to heaven. I saw God. And then eventually God pushed me back down. And when I woke up, I was a baby and you named me Luke.
Now she was really confused.
She called me and said, you know, something weird is going on.
Erica's mom, Lisa Trump, remembered a book she'd read in the 70s by the late Dr. Ian Stevenson, who clinically studied past life claims.
We started to realize that perhaps we did actually have something there.
But with a terrifying twist.
So I decided to go ahead and ask him further, do you remember how you died? And he looked right at me and said, well, yeah, it was a fire. And at that point, he made like a motion with his hand, like he was jumping off of a building.
A tall building in a big city where Luke said he walked a lot and took the train.
I was like, you're sure it's Chicago? He said, yes, I remember it was Chicago.
Erica plugged the information into the internet.
And that's when I came across the Paxton Hotel.
The Paxton Hotel, a residential building in a predominantly African-American Chicago neighborhood.
You know, just asked him, I was very casual about it, like, Lukey, what color was Pam's skin? And he just looked right up at me like, duh, black.
In March 1993, a massive fire raced through the property, trapping most residents. 19 died, including a woman in her 30s named Pamela Robinson.
Pam had jumped out of a window to her death. I was really kind of weirded out by it at this point.
And it was about to get stranger. While working with the documentary show Ghost Inside My Child on the Lifetime Movie Network.
You want to look at these pictures?
Erica and Luke's dad decided to put the now five-year-old to the test.
I had found a picture of Pam, and we had put it on a sheet of paper with a bunch of fake pictures.
What's familiar mean? Like,
I didn't really think that he was going to pick the right one.
But with the cameras rolling,
I know someone I can recognize.
But I remember when this one was taken, and he pointed to the correct one.
So Pam.
Took me a couple days to wrap my head around it. I couldn't sleep. I thought about it constantly.
They say immediately their thoughts turned to Pam's family still in Chicago. We reached out to them. They said no comment at this time. However, a family member did speak with Erica, and she says she discovered even more similarities. God
bless the child who's got. I know that Pam was a big, like, Stevie Wonder fan, and Luke, like, really likes that era of music. She played the keyboard a lot. And one of the things that Luke, his favorite toy at the time was this little tiny piano that he would tote around with him.
And just as Erica was becoming truly connected with Pam's memory, Luke let her go.
It's like he got it all out, he was finished, and he had nothing more to say about it.
But the family continues to share their journey with anyone who will listen, not seeking fame or fortune.
We didn't receive any money for the show.
They tell Luke's story because they say it's a message that needs to be told.
It's a positive one. It is one of unification. It is one of love.
I think it tells us that we shouldn't define the soul by race or gender out of the mouth of babes.